What to Play presents the top 10 PS4 zombie games of all time, all arranged by PlayScore. To check out our full list, visit our website at whattoplay.com. You can also take part in our rankings by leaving reviews of the games that you played. Link in the description box below. Frank West. Opening our list at number 10 is Dead Rising. When it comes to zombie games, none can resist Frank West's charm. The first of the Dead Rising series, this over-the-top parody of the zombie genre still hasn't lost its touch after 10 years. This HD remaster has a few noteworthy additions to satisfy fans. This includes a visual rework, adding more lighting to your zombie-slaying escapades. It's still set in a shopping mall full of ravenous undead, but nothing's better than fending them off using everyday tools found in each corner. A play score of an 8.92. Ninth on our list, Zombie Army 4 – Dead War. Anyone familiar with the Zombie Army saga knows that it's one hell of a ride. With the word zombie stapled into its name, it's safe to say that this game is all about an army of relentless flesh eaters. Dead War puts a unique spin on the genre. Here, you're fighting zombified Nazis and eventually zombie Hitler as well. Yep, you heard that right. It doesn't take itself too seriously. From the creators of the famed Sniper Elite series, expect satisfying gunplays and slow-mos in a thrilling cooperative shooter experience. It's one of those rare games where its DLCs add more content to play with friends, or alone. A play score of an 8.15. At 8th place is Killing Floor 2. Speaking of playing with friends, Killing Floor 2 is also a strong multiplayer zombie game where you mindlessly slay thousands of these horrid creatures in a visceral rampage. Teaming up with up to 6 players may or may not be fun, depending on who you play with. With a wide arsenal of tools at your disposal, what's not to love about this kick-ass game? The endless slaughtering creates more room to experiment, like choosing the right perk or weapon. It's a recommended PvE title for anyone even mildly interested in the genre. A play score of an 8.25. Seventh spot belongs to Days Gone. Bend Studios' ambitious open-world zombie game received a lot of praise during its time as a timed PlayStation 4 exclusive. As a third-person adventure, the post-apocalyptic world is ripe for exploration and teeming with dangerous creatures that roam in packs. Good thing we have our motorcycle to keep us company. Days Gone's sheer presentation of a legion of bloodthirsty monsters is the game's strongest aspect. It's a shame we never get to see a sequel. But hey, at least it's coming to the PC next month. It receives a play score of an 8.33. Ranked 6th is Dying Light. One of the fresher IPs that reinvented the zombie genre, Dying Light was Techland's answer to the lack of a Dead Island sequel. Most of its gameplay is borrowed from their other first-person zombie project, especially the melee combat. The game's main selling point, aside from the zombies, is its fluid movement. Parkour your way around abandoned streets and run away from the hungry undead. At night, the game gets even crazier with the presence of even more powerful creatures. It's a combination of survival horror and action-adventure elements. A sequel is coming soon, but who knows when it'll come out. Dying Light receives a play score of an 8.39. Halfway through the list, we have Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare. Hey, PopCap's goofy tower defense franchise is still a zombie game, you know. Garden Warfare puts a major twist on the usual rivalry between these two unlikely creatures. It's a multiplayer third-person shooter that's loosely based on notable shooters like Call of Duty. Pick a side and dominate the lush green gardens using a selection of powerful weapons, each unique to certain plants or zombies. Its sequels didn't get enough play scores to take the spot, but they did a better job improving on the core mechanics. Garden Warfare receives a play score of an 8.49. Fourth place is Death Road to Canada. Between these AAA titles is an indie game that manages to do zombie games just right. For starters, it's a randomly generated road trip that involves you and a group of strangers making it out alive. It's a comical adventure built with high replay value. Each run offers new kinds of surprises. you're still facing off against a swarm of undead, but the weapons, companions, and power-ups you acquire will either be game-changing or not. It receives a play score of an 8.50. At third place is The Walking Dead Season 2. Telltale Games, a series of episodic dramas set around Robert Kirkman's post-apocalyptic stories, broke our hearts the first time it came out. Clementine and Lee Everett's journey into the broken hellscape was something special. In Season 2, we get to see a more mature Clem surviving the harsh world. Still on that episodic format, it lets you enjoy 5 episodes of high-stakes decision-making, with each chapter packed with shock value and major twists that will leave you wanting more. It's a shame we'll never see these games in the future. A play score of an 8.58. Second spot is Resident Evil 2 Remake. It's not a zombie list without the king of the genre. Capcom's award-winning Resident Evil series has been with us for 25 years, making it a household name, creating numerous books, TV shows, and live-action movies. Ugh. Everyone's fully aware of this RE engine upgrade of Claire and Leon's stories during Raccoon City's fall. It's the highest play score game of the RE titles for the PS4. And there are a lot of them piling up on this ranking. With RE8 already making waves, their vampire mommies and werewolves might just make the list next. RE2 Remake has a play score of a 9.27. And at number 1 is The Last of Us Remastered. Naughty Dog's award-winning post-apocalyptic drama takes the top spot. These spore-infected freaks are zombies too, you know. Joel and Ellie's journey around this godforsaken world has enough drama to power a TV show. Wait, there's already one coming! Experience Sony's third-person action adventure with new and improved visuals and enhanced lighting. Perfect for anyone who owns a massive TV. Together with The Last of Us Part 2, they revamped the classic genre, injecting a well-written narrative that hits close to home. A play score of a 9.41.